Thank you so much for welcoming me to your home. I'm here for your consultation for some design features. Yes. So I know that you are looking to spice things up with a new window treatment and carpeting. Did I get it right? Okay, wonderful. So for window treatments, I brought two different styles for you to pick from, just so that we know the direction that you're willing to go to. I brought some samples for wooden blinds, both real wood and faux or fake wood, and also some cellular shades as an option too. Yep, we'll go over them in just a second. And for carpeting, I brought a few samples with me too, so I can show you the different height of the pile of the carpets, so we can pay attention to these more shag looking carpets versus just plush carpets. Yeah, we'll just look at them up close and consider all of the options to make sure that at the end of the day you're satisfied and you have the product that will last you the longest and that you will love for the long time, okay? So now, I see that your preferences in colors are quite neutral, yeah? I noticed some beiges, colorings, some beiges and browns. I also see some grays that are both warm and cool. I think that's absolutely wonderful. It creates a very neutral background for more accented pieces that are more interesting and will attract more eye. But everything else looks very uniformed and clean and simple. Sometimes that's what we want in specifically window treatments and flooring of any kind. Unless you're trying to make a statement, of course. So these are actually my favorite shades as well to work with specifically for these materials. So I think we're going to be a great team in this. I know you're also interested in a kitchen too. We'll do that some other time, yeah? Okay, I think that's a good idea. So without any further ado, you have any questions right now? Okay, let's just jump right into samplings and we'll pick some of the best options that we can offer you at this time, okay? Alright, let's take a look at it. So let's take a look at our wooden and wood blinds samples I've brought for you here. Okay. So today we're going to go through three major steps, if this will be your choice. Step number one, choosing the materials and sled size. Number two, picking your finishes. Number three are some extra decorative choices that you can pick from. Okay? And at any point, any time, if you have any questions, I'm here for you, okay? So here's the difference between a wood and faux wood, or man-made plastic or composed material. So hardwood is timeless, as you know. It is a very classic style. If you have hardwoods in your home or a lot of wood grained furniture, I would suggest for you to go with more of a wood look. However, nowadays, technology has taken us so far that we can replicate the wood grains on a more practical material. materials. They're just easier to maintain, that live longer. The positive of wood, again, is elegance and the fact that it is real wood. The negative is that if you have a climate of humidity, higher humidity or exposure to water, wood could get damaged a little bit and potentially warp over time, but again, you are getting hardwood, so that's that. No explanation needed. So here are some slat sizes that we offer you. We have this 2.5 inch one. Then we have this 2 inch one. And this one, which is 1 inch. You would pick these by usually the size of your window. So more grander views and larger windows look better with larger slats on them. More of a medium window or smaller windows suggested to have smaller slats. Also, it depends on how you like to wipe your window blinds. Larger surfaces sometimes are easier to clean. So just something for you to consider. This is real wood here. So here's the library of all the different shades of beautiful real wood blinds that we offer. You can see we have some grays with wood grain. With wood grains in here. More browns on the bottom, right here, and some darks such as matte black, this espresso, and this reclaimed split look. More of black shades here, more dark shades. Still quite appealing though, yeah. That's that all, of course. Of course, we offer you different shades here too. More warmer, more earthier tones. So if you have lighter wood on your flooring, I would always suggest going with lighter window treatments too. And of course, again, you can match it the color of your flooring or furniture to make it more universal and make it look more stylish, more subtle, I want to say. So here we have our library of white shades too. And we have some warmer tones. Some cooler tones of white, some wood grain here too. You can see the difference between more flat surface and a bit more wood grain surface. Okay. Of course, we have our bright white classic shade, which is one of the more popular ones. Depending on where you live, if it's community or association, you might have to go with white shades. And if not, then you have all of these choices presented to you, okay? So let's look at some faux wood or composite materials here. So here we also can replicate the wood grain. These ones. your flooring as well, or your furniture if you would wish to. Or you can go with just surfaced color, like this gray one. And again, a couple of different very popular color choices for you here. Here, of course, we have a larger amount of white colors. These are very popular shades, blinds to get in white, specifically fake wood or faux wood. We have again very nice grainy textured ones, or just more flat surface without any grain, so you can tell that it's not real wood. Here we have warmer here too, more yellows, and of course more cooler white shades too. Here we have just classic white bright. Once again, sometimes it is preferred to have white on your windows, like right here, just to make it fit the color of your actual windowsill and window frame, so it looks more more well put together and as a set. Okay. All right. So now we can pick some more details. So, we offer different tapes, decorative touches, and that's the part that holds your blinds together between each other and its own self. So, we'd like lighter shades. We have these beautiful beige tones. Some of them have designs. Some are more neutral, more flat. We have also very earthy olive shades, browns, more on the red side. Okay. And then for darker colors, more subtle look with white, with either design or no design. And of course, just down the line to the dark. Something you will be left with. You know what your thoughts are on those. If this is, of course, the direction you're going with. Okay. So, another thing right here we'll be making a choice on is the style of valance and the little tassels or wand that come with it. Okay. So, right here you can see. We have traditional, transitional, and contemporary styles to offer you. You can see them right here. So traditional style looks, has just more angles, more surfaces that stick out a bit. It is a very established look. It looks sharp. Has a little bit more fine details, and this is our wand that comes with it. Also quite stylish, quite traditional. Then transitional is a more symmetrical, aesthetic look. It's clean, yet still has some detailing on it. Okay, and this is our pool right here. And then we have our contemporary. It is very softened, curved, and sweeping lines. It doesn't have much detail to it besides this one little raised lip. It looks more modern, for it right here. Okay. So you could always pick these valances. This is simply the part that goes right above the window blind. Okay. And we also have this white one in classic. Is it just tassel or just a string? Okay. Just a very simple boxed in look. Wooden blinds. Okay, so let's look at our cellular shades. Now, cellular shades are a more modern approach to window treatments. They're just a little bit easier to maintain, and they're much more affordable than blinds of different kinds, especially wooden blinds. Of course, the choice is yours to make. Okay, so I'll just show you different styles that we offer. So we'll need to do three different steps. We'll need to choose our fabric style. We need to pick the light and energy control, and then some extra options for colors and such. Okay? So when picking the fabric, you want to think about the style, the textures that you're looking for. So here you see we have a few. Here we have some heathered look, tree bark. Selections, linen look, sheer, and design and textures. We also have some value fabrics that are a little bit more affordable, such as this earth, ergot, classic, and designer colors. Okay. So this is something you will be left with to decide on your own. So you can think about all the different types of textures that you prefer. You can match it to already existing fabrics in your room. Okay. So now the light energy. Okay. There are usually two different types. So there's light filtering, sheer, and so here you can see the difference. This is the room darkening. This is the light filtering. And you can tell that light filtering option is allowing light through, while the room darkening keeps it nice and dark. We do have this specific light shield that diffuses the light around it, doesn't let it through, and protects your valuable items in your home from light exposure. Okay, this is the value fabrics. Is often a little bit darker in shade, but you can get different ones, okay? So again, you can see room darkening versus light filtering. It is just something that you have to consider for yourself. usually in the bedrooms, most of our clients go with room darkening. And then in living rooms and kitchens and dining rooms, they usually pick the light filtering. Because you still want some light to come in to your house. You just don't want the UV lights penetrating necessarily. Okay? And these come in double cells. What double cell does is it insulates your window 2 times more. So you can sleep safe and know that you're going to be protected from all elements, from both heat and cold in winter. Okay? So that's something you want to pick up. Okay. So we'll just go through a few of these symbols first. So here's sand, for example, quite nice color. This is a heathered look for you. This sea olive one looks quite nice too. So heathered is just interest, more dimension in the color. Okay. Here's the tree bark. Always symbols for you on the side here. Okay. Which one? So here's tree bark. These are good for bedrooms. These are room darkening. It's more of a natural, inspired look, texture that has nature in mind, as well as shades and colors here too, quite coordinated to a more natural approach. Okay, so here's our seclusion. Some light shades here, some white, and this one's quite a simple texture, but it does have a little bit of interest too. You can see some little patterns, threads, it's like twined threading. To choose from too. Okay. Here's a biscuit color, very nice. Looks very appealing and inviting. Okay. This is linen. If you've ever attached linen material, fabric, quite nice and grainy, I want to say. So here's some nice rosemary. It's just kind of jumping right at us. Very nice, almost sheer look to it. See? Okay. Here's the petal pearl. A little bouncy light shining through. Here's a light gray, quite popular too. And this one's again a more of a sheer look. If this is something you're going for. Here are our designer textures. We have a few more in these to try. And these are more bright, vibrant. So here's also a light It's very nice and smooth, almost a velvety-like texture. You will notice. Try it. Here's a good slate color too for a bedroom. It's kind of off-green, brown shade. It's quite popular. Aqua is popular for bathrooms, like here. They're very nice and soft. And some lighter shades here too. So we have whisper, very nice word, whisper, and again all of these are done single cells, like this, and they all come first on top as light filtering, on the bottom is room darkening. Okay, so you can always pick and choose. Alright. Here's our sheer fabrics. Not too many of our customers pick sheer ones, to be honest, because they do have the lowest energy saving rating. But it is still an option for you. You can see there's no backing, so it will let light right through. Especially in these lighter shades, like the snow one. You can see that it's quite a see-through. But at the same time, it allows more picturesque views for your home, if this is your choice and your wish. Okay? So here's our value. Fabrics. Okay. Here's a snow one. It's a bit more reflective. You can see that it reflects light a bit. And these are also double cell, which means it protects from the sun a little bit better. Okay. So here are also some designer colors, so you don't really have to go with any of the other ones. You can always pick one of these shades, like this aqua, so quite nice. You can see room darkening versus light filtering, also double cell. Just gonna make it look more stacked against your window. So some of the colors, shades of blue, more neutral tones, more colorful tones here and there, okay? And so here's classic line. These are single cells. Room darkening versus light filtering. This is a more subtle texture. A lot of our customers love this. It's more of a classic option, obviously. Okay? So you have a lot to choose from. The only cons with cellular shades is that they don't last too long. On average, the warranty is about 10 to 15 years on some material. The good is that a lot of these are DIY if you wish, a DIY project, or if not, then can be installed for quite an affordable rate considering that their options for like wood shutters, they cost way more for installation. These are just very simple installation. So this is that for you too. So let me show you some samples of our carpets. I know that you had questions about carpets too, right? Okay. So there are most of the time two different styles of carpets that we offer and that you might want to consider. One is a very classic, timeless style. That is just plush. So it has a short pile height. You can see it's only about half an inch or under. And usually it's quite soft, nice and durable, very timeless look, elegant. So here we have choices of different shades of it for you. Mostly it's neutrals, as you requested. And mostly in warm or cool grays. So we have some of these more beige shades. This one I love a lot. These grays. Beautiful as well. So it has a little bit of little dotting inclusions that give you a bit of a lighter shade, but also still a darker carpet. And you would pick blush for bedrooms if you wish, for high trafficked areas. The only thing is that blush does show footprints or vacuum marks, so that's something that you need to consider. The other style that I will show you doesn't always show those, okay? So here we have lighter colors, beiges, white. Brown shades here as well, just kind of off browns, but as you can tell, they're all very neutral. Would go with any style and also look good together. If you were to change some in different rooms, if some of your bedrooms are going to be one shade, living room is the other shade, for example. So these are your choices here. Okay. Have a couple more on the other side. In multiple colors, in multicolors. So that's when the increments included have different shadings in. So it doesn't look like one color, it looks like a few different colors. This one's a bit more shagier texture. But also we have just the lighter or darker shades. Okay. Do you like any of these? Second style of the carpet. It has the longer dots. They're also curled, twisted, unlike the plush carpet that we just looked at. So these are modern day shag carpets. more beiges here, and more brown, green, earthy tones here. Okay. Do you like any of these at all? Well, these are good for, again, high trafficked areas. They're also very nice and soft and plush. Yet they don't leave the markings of footprints and vacuum marks and such. Okay. Yes, absolutely. I can leave you with some samples if you wish. That's what I have a couple right here for you prepared. Do you like this kind? Mm-hmm. Okay. So we will stay with you then. So more of a shag rug. This is more plush, so it's a shorter pile height. Very nice and soft and smooth. This one's similar, but a bit more rough. A more affordable option too. It's going to withstand more traffic. Mm-hmm. This one, I believe, actually had the same one. So I'll leave you with these ones, correct? Okay. So I hope that this was helpful to you. Please let me know your decision. What exactly you're going to go with, so I can place the order and we can go on and continue with plans for installation. Thank you for having me.